The 4004, U.S. patent number 3821715, the world's first single-chip microprocessor, was invented by Intel in 1971, just 3 years after the company was founded. That same year, Intel also introduced the first erasable programmable memory, the EEPROM. The combination of computer chip and memory became the foundation for the personal computer revolution. It all began in the summer of 1969. Busicom, a Japanese calculator maker, hired a small company of 100 employees to design a set of 12 custom chips for a family of programmable calculators. The project was assigned to a young engineer, Ted Hoff. In an interview from Intel's archives, he recalls looking at the design Busicom proposed and thinking there had to be a better way.
But there are quite a few chips that were going to have to be developed. Altogether, I think there might have been 10 or 12 different chips. Now, there was a keyboard scanner, there were printer controllers, there were display controllers, then there was arithmetic.
Hoff was surprised at how complex the calculator design was, and eventually he came up with a different approach.
I started looking at an architecture based on the calculator requirements, but trying to reduce the instructions, elementary operations down to the simplest possible.
Instead of building a dozen hardwired chips, Hoff had the idea of creating a single general purpose information processor that could be modified by programs stored in memory. Another engineer, Stan Mazur, soon joined Hoff on the project, and together the two men worked out the architecture for what would become Intel's first microprocessor. To turn Hoff and Mazur's idea into silicon reality, Intel hired design engineer Federico Fagin.
Federico just took off like a rocket. I mean, and he just worked around the clock. And he got all, there were really three complex chips plus one that was quite simple. And he had them all designed by the end of the year.
The final design involved a set of four chips called the MCS4. They included a central processing unit, the 4004, the memory, and input-output controllers. Fagin, in an interview from Intel's archives, recalls testing the first wafers. The night they came off the production line in Mountain View, California, was a eureka moment for him.
I was alone in the lab, and basically I spent the whole night probing and checking, and basically I didn't find a single mistake all night, and so I was absolutely elated. I mean, it was the night that the 4004 was born.
Some at Intel were skeptical at first of the 4004's potential. The company, however, eventually bought the rights to market the invention for non-calculator applications, and it returned the $60,000 development cost to Busicom, which had become strapped for cash. About the size of a piece of candy, the 4004 incorporated 2,300 transistors and had as much computing power as ENIAC, the world's first electronic computer, which was called the giant brain when unveiled in 1946. The first computer on a chip could execute 60,000 instructions per second, primitive by today's standards, but a breakthrough performance back then. Intel publicly introduced the 4004 to the world on November 15, 1971, with an ad in Electronic News.
It was a completely new type of component, so it's very clear that there was it was not going to be, it was not going to be so, that easy to sell a component that essentially is a computer on a chip.
While the 4004 did not have very high performance, it was used in a number of controlled applications. 5 months after the 4004 was introduced, Intel launched the 8008, which had twice the compute performance. The computer chip era now rushed forward. Intel co-founder Gordon Moore, in an interview from the company's archives, said other generations of microprocessors rapidly followed, most notably the 386, Intel's highly successful 32-bit computer chip.
At that time, the microprocessor was already significant and growing rapidly. This was in 1985, actually the year that our first 32-bit microprocessor was introduced, the good old 386. We had seen a couple of successful generations in the PC already, and in fact, that turned out to be the beginning of a very major development in microprocessors for us, really the development of the modern PC. So it was a very important time in Intel's history.
Thank you.